What was the thing that kind of creatively stirred you up?
Creatively, it was playing a detective that's a rookie, that's inexperienced, and that grows, you know, having the opportunity for him to grow per episode. You know, there's been a lot of procedural shows where you have a detective who has it figured out. You know, he's been on the force for so long. But you get to kind of watch this guy make mistakes, you know, be naive, insecure, and he's kind of the odd man out at the police station. So I think the most fun has been balancing him growing and maturing and getting comfortable in those shoes as a detective.
How much of his backstory do you know going into it? Were you given pretty detailed information about who this guy is?
You know, well, all I knew is that they told me that they wanted a vibe of like Cleavon Little and like Shaft, you know, and so it was more vibe. I got more of a vibe, less about his background. I knew he was a rookie. And that's what I kind of really sucked my teeth into. It was like, you know, I was on this show called Breakout Kings on A&E. Oh, thanks. Yeah. Yeah. And so when I was working on that show, I watched a lot of A&E shows, and I watched a lot of First 48. And in First 48, you can see so many rookie detectives. So I rewatched them and looked at them. I mean, everyone's, your first day on the job, you know, everybody has, they make their mistakes and they have like a learning curve. And I think just playing with that, you know, just playing with that. But I think of episode 4, you do find out a little bit about his backstory, what led to him being a detective, and you get to watch him and Liv relationship grow from there.
Do you like him being the odd man out? He doesn't know she's the zombie. Do you like him thinking she's a psychic, or do you hope that he's going to learn the truth?
You know, I like it because, you know, they're both odd men out, you know? You know, she's going, you know, I don't think he'll ever figure out she's a zombie. I think he's reserving the fact of your emo goth. When I first got the role, I Googled emo. I didn't know what that was. I knew what goth was, but I didn't know what emo was. So I gave a Google search on emo. I'm like, that's Liv. I'm like, it's usually dark hair, but they got the white hair. And I'm like, so he thinks he packed her. That's your fashion. This is what you listen to, emo punk. And to each his own, that's fine. In terms of the zombie thing, unless he smells brains on a breath or something, but I don't think he knows what brains smell like. You know? Plus, he covers it up with, you know, hot sauce and things. So I don't think he'll ever... I don't think he'll ever figure out the zombie aspect, but I think what really connects him is the fact that he's an odd man out at the police station, and she's also an odd person out just in society. Just, you know, and then being a psychic on top of that. So I think that's what connects
him. Is that what you like most about playing that relationship? I mean, they're so fun to watch together and try and figure out. Is that what you love most?
I love that part. You know, I love that part. You know, we both have the same goals in mind. You know, in mind. You know, we're both. Which, you know, she found a new purpose, you know, in terms of bringing these murder victims, killers to justice, and getting something out of that. Obviously, I don't know if she gets their brains and she gets to inherit their personalities and characteristics and learn from that. But it's still, I have the same goals with other factors for my own personal reasons, for his own personal reasons. But I think, you know, I think it's fun playing with that.
I mean, obviously, what she provides for him is useful and helpful, but will people around him continue to question, you know, him using her?
Yeah. And well, like, you know, I think Clive, like, there was a monologue in the pilot where he said he believes in psychics. He goes, my great aunt Debbie was a psychic. You know, she predicted the sex of 9 of my cousins, you know. And so he confides in, he tells Liv that in the pilot. So he believes in psychics, you know. I mean, he says, you know, so if someone said, oh, that's not true, whatever like that, he goes say, well, my great aunt, I'm telling you, is real. You know, and maybe she'll be introduced in the season somewhere. I don't know. But he believes it. But we'll see. We'll see.
Rob is one of those special writer producers that has a very passionate fan following of his own that were interested in the show coming in. is that an interesting experience for you to kind of be a part of a show like that that comes in almost pre-sold to a certain fan base?
Yeah. It's great. I think what's really interesting about it is just, obviously it's great to go into something that has support behind it and that has people, a lot of positive energy behind it and people rooting for it, really, really rooting for it before it comes out. So just kind of be a part of that has been, it's been great. It's been great. And getting to learn, meet the Veronica Mars fans and Party Down fans, and just it's just a great. We obviously supported fan base because they funded the movie, and so just to kind of be ingratiated into that has been awesome.
So given how the supernatural element of the show is kind of like slowly expanding, becoming like more and more prevalent, how do you think that your character is going to be able to stay out of that and stay ignorant?
He doesn't. Actually, in this, Clive starts to start getting pulled into the serialized aspect of it. It's always right underneath his nose. How long will it stay underneath his nose? I don't know. I really don't know. But I think there's no way he can, because the world, it's not like, it is a supernatural world, but we do have like the Night of Living Dead DVDs. I'm sure Liv probably watches The Walking Dead when she goes home, So it's grounded in our reality in a sense. So there's no way I would think if she says, I'm a zombie and I eat brains. Like, how would I process it? Like, he wouldn't really process that because zombies aren't known to function. So, but if he, so it's going to be, I don't even know if Clive can handle that. So actually, I don't know how. I have no idea.
Do you think that he, in some, in his subconscious, he knows he's just choosing to kind of overlook it? Yes, you said, the ant factor and the belief, but shouldn't look like his aunt. Like, his aunt didn't look like that.
Yeah.
And do some of that stuff and react the same way.
Yeah.
So it's like, do you think that he's kind of consciously letting it go and kind of passing over it in order to just get the job done?
Yeah, I'm interested to see what happens when he becomes more confident at it. I think it's more of a, as he becomes more successful, where he kind of, where maybe he'll get to a point where he goes, I think I got this without you, which happens, here and there, throughout the rest of the season. But maybe. I think that's something to be seen.
I love the interactions between the two of you. I think it's like the perfect little team.
Yeah.
You tolerate her, it's like a brother-sister type.
Yeah.
Annoyance, but at the same time, oh no.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed that dynamic. How long did it take you guys to just kind of gel that?
We always talked about the progression of their relationship. We were like, they're not really friends in the first episode, the second episode. At what point do they become friends? Which changes the dynamic completely. And there's a point, there's a point in the season where that happens, it strengthens the dynamic, going forward. But they're more like buddies right now and helping each other out. Episode 3, Clive wasn't even on that situation. She brought him into this whole entire thing to put his career on the line, and it ended up being something that's really, really great for him, and she created a lot of separation, yeah. So I think he's indebted to her because of that, because she didn't have to do that, but I think when you see them become friends, it'll be the dynamic is very, very strong after that. It's stronger.